Greetings, I am Herbert Erpaderp, and today I'm going to build this S Model Crusader. This kit can make either the Crusader Mk1 or Mk2, or, because you can build two tanks with this kit, you could build one of each. This is a 1/72 scale plastic model with some photo etch metal parts, though it makes no mention of those photo etch parts on the box, at least not in English, unless I've missed it. Like the other S model kits I've looked at, the box has a clean and simple look. The back of the box is upside down, relative to the rest of the box, but that's not really an issue, is it? And we can deal with it easily. As you can see, there are illustrations of the sides, front and rear of the model, with a basic painting guide. There's also a couple of warnings about things like studying the instructions and not using glue or paint near open flame or sparks, which is disappointing. I was hoping to work under a nice shower of sparks. Okay, that might be a lie. Let's look at what's in the box. Because you can build two tanks with this kit, there are obviously two of these sprues, one for each tank. As I've come to expect from S Model, the parts on these sprues are very clean and neat. I wasn't able to find any defects or deformities or anything like that, and while there are mold lines, they're rather minor and will be easy to clean up. It seems like they've engineered this kit in such a way that the mold lines are in places where they would either be hidden or very easy to remove, and not across any important details. The details on these parts look pretty decent. While you probably wouldn't call them super detailed, they do look quite good and all of the important things are there. The details are fairly fine and not chunky like wargaming models tend to be. I'll leave that up to you to decide whether that's good or bad or somewhere in between. The only problem I have here is that there won't be anything left over for my bits box. Not a real problem at all. Unlike pretty much all wargaming kits though, this comes with some photo etch parts. These look like they might be a little bit less frustrating than the photo etch on the Hotchkiss H35 that I built a while ago, link in the description and card in the upper right corner. It looks like there are some spares on these frets, which is awesome. Photo etch parts are very easy to lose after all. Decals are also included. I still haven't used any of the decals from the S model kits I've built before, so I can't speak of their quality just yet, but they do look decent enough. As with a lot of kits, instructions are included. These are fairly simple. In fact, there's only really one page of actual instructions, not that there really needs to be more. These are simple to follow and easily understood. Most of the space in this leaflet is taken up by decal placement guides and painting suggestions, though they are all pretty similar paint schemes, except that one camo version, which I do find kind of appealing. Of note, the only difference in the two versions of the Crusader this kit builds is the presence or lack of a machine gun turret at the front of the hull. I've decided to build this one with a turret, but we'll get to that later. Let's start at the beginning, which the instructions suggest is to build the turret. First, I take the main gun, which has the coaxial machine gun molded onto it. This part is quite nice. The gun comes with a hole in the end of the barrel, so I don't need to drill that out. This is something I always appreciate. The gun part is slotted in through the back of the mantlet, which would be this part here. It goes into place easily. It should be pretty obvious which gun goes through which slot. I add glue to bond it in place, and then I nudge the gun into the elevation that I want it to be at. I leave that to sit and bond for a while I join the two halves of the turret shell together. This is very easy, and there are guide pins and corresponding sockets that make it simple. Before pushing the parts all the way together, I put glue in between the two halves, slide them together, and then apply pressure to deal with any possible gaps. The result is quite nice, with minimal gappage. I then add glue to the front of the turret and press the mantlet and main gun assembly into place. There is a bit of a gap around this, but I think there should be a slight gap there anyway. After all, these plates are riveted together and not welded or cast, so I guess a slight gap would make sense. Next, I glue the stowage box onto the rear of the turret. This being a British tank, it's probably mostly used for storing tea. The instructions don't say to add this part just yet, but I figured why not? It's not going to hurt anything. Or will it? No. Then I attach this teeny tiny searchlight. It's tiny and rounded, so of course it's quite fiddly and hard to grip with tweezers. So, fat fingers it is. It actually went into place pretty easily after a bit of nudging. And that's the turret completed. Well, except for some photo etch parts, but we'll get to those later. Right now, we've got a hull to build. Much like the turret, the upper and lower halves of the hull go together quite easily, and there are guide pins to help with this, which is nice. I applied pressure, especially at the front, to help minimise gaps, though strictly speaking I don't think it was really necessary. It is always good to be sure though. Certainly looks like a Crusader hull. Then come the tracks. These are a nicely detailed single piece. There are mounting holes in the drive sprocket and idler wheels, and corresponding poles at the front and rear of the hull. These look to be slightly different in size, though I didn't really check. So to avoid possibly having a weird backwards Crusader, the drive sprocket, with the pointy teeth, should be at the rear of the tank. The track parts slide onto the pins nice and easily. A little pressure to be sure they're all the way against the side of the hull, and they're on. As you can see, I didn't bother cleaning up the mess from the sprues on the upper sections of track. The reason for that is they will be covered by the side skirts, which come next. The positioning of these is guided nicely by some tabs and posts, so they're pretty easy to get into place, though you may find you need to push them upwards a bit and definitely apply some pressure in towards the hull. I tried to get everything as gap-free as possible and I did okay. Might need to do some filling, at least at the front fenders, though I believe the gaps there aren't too bad. Then I add the headlamps. The one with the visor thing, whatever that's called, should be on the tank's right. Like the spotlight on the turret, these are tiny and fiddly and difficult to use tweezers on, but they're not that hard to get into place. You just need to do a little bit of careful nudging. They're not perfectly straight, but they're close enough. Then comes the front of the driver's compartment. There's a couple of tabs that lock into a pair of holes at the bottom of this part, and it's as easy to put into place as it looks. I apply a little pressure in an effort to minimize gaps, and then I move to the rear of the tank and attach the external fuel drum. There's a couple of recesses for the upper points of the mounting bracket to sit in, and the lower points just rest against the hull. Very simple, but effective enough. At this point, the instructions also seem to want me to add the MG turret, or of course the hatch part that covers the hole after the turret's deletion if you're building that version of the Crusader. I thought if I were to glue this into place now, it would interfere with the installation of the photo etch brush guards on the headlamps. So I'm going to leave it off for now, but this is what it looks like. I think you'll agree that it's certainly a turret with little guns in it. And because there isn't really anything else left to do now, I installed a photo etch, starting with those brush guards, which, as you can see, are quite fine. I apply glue to either end of the part, and then gently put them in place with tweezers. Apologies for the blurry video, this was a bit fiddly and I'd stopped paying attention to the camera. Not shown is the trillion times I messed this up. That might be a slight exaggeration, but not by much. There is a tiny little guide hole in the upper front plate for these, and the longer bits just seem to hang down onto the lower front plate. It does look a little bit messy, but this wasn't quite as fiddly as some of the photo etch that was on the H35 that I built a while ago, so that's nice. And in the end, it does look nicer than some of the more chunky plastic brush guard parts that you get in some kits. Then I glue the machine gun turret into its place like so. Very simple. You don't have to face yours to the front like mine, but I thought it would look good that way. This would have definitely got in the way of installing the brush guards and caused some irritation. It's probably more accurate to say extra irritation, really. It looks good, but there's still some more photo etch to add. These are lift rings for the turret. These were easier to attach than the brush guards, but still a little bit fiddly. They should mount onto some little rectangles on the sides of the turret like so. It's worth noting that the instructions seem to point out the wrong mounting point for the rear lift rings. They should be on the smaller rectangle a bit further back than what the instructions indicate. You may notice that the part is flat. When it's glued on, you can bend it just a little bit so there's an angle. The lifting part of the lift ring should be vertical. I think these actually look pretty good, and on this tank it feels less photo etch for the sake of having photo etch like the Hotchkiss did. There's still a bit of mess caused by my own incompetence with the superglue, but that's not too bad, and it can be dealt with. What matters is the 1/72nd scale Crusader by S Model is now complete and ready to go crusading, and I think it's a really nice looking model. In my opinion, Crusaders are pretty interesting to start with, especially that angular turret. I don't think I would like to ride one into battle, but they're nice to look at, and I think this model is a pretty decent representation of a Crusader, whichever mark you choose to build. The build was fun, for the most part anyway. I did get a little bit frustrated with the photo etch, mostly the brush guards, but I have dealt with worse. The photo etch probably took up most of the time in this build. The plastic components went together very quickly and easily. I guess that's why the box says it's a quick build kit. It's good to know they weren't lying. The plastic parts of this kit were a pleasure to put together, like I said, quick and easy. Only very minimal mold line removal was required, which of course makes the process that much quicker. I do like the option to build the Crusader with and without the MG turret. It's literally only one part difference between the two versions of the tank, and that hatch part is all that's left for my bits box, but that's okay. It's still an option, and I do like options. In my opinion, the detailing on this model looks pretty good. It's obviously not a super complicated display kit or anything like that, and I'm pretty sure S Model intend their kits for wargamers, but it does still look quite nicely detailed. I guess it's really something of a hybrid between display models and wargaming kits. The photo etch parts kind of suggest that to me. I'm sure photo etch is fairly uncommon in this scale too, which gives S Model something relatively unique. I guess the downside to that is some of their kits having photo etch just for the sake of having photo etch, like the H35, but in this case it's worked wonderfully. I think this might actually be my favourite of the three S Model kits I've built so far, and there are definitely going to be more. I'm pretty sure that I saw a Soviet T-35 in the hobby shop last time I was there. It was a bit more expensive than this kit, but I think I'll go and get that. Nobody go and buy it before I get there, or I'll be so mad. I think that might be enough rambling. What do you guys think of the S Model Crusader? Let me know in the comments below. Also, if you haven't already, why not do all the liking, subbing, and following things here on YouTube, Twitch, and my other social media places. And if you really like the things I do, please consider supporting over on Patreon, where you will now be able to see my videos up to 4 days early. Or you could purchase a shirt or mug from my merch store. Links to all of the things I just mentioned are in the description below. And as always, I shall return soon. So until then, be excellent to each other and thanks for watching. Farewell.